Welcome back. In last two videos, we have learned linear regression to fit a linear model to data. But how do you know the quality of the fitting? In this video, we will learn about measure of quality of our linear model. Here, I have five data points. Let's assume a model that is very bad. Our Oates model is that y is independent of x. That means y is equal to a constant. The constant can be any value. But to make our Oates model meaningful, let's assume y is equal to the average of y. So y is equal to y bar. Then actually for this model, we can say that y is equal to y bar. But due to the error in our measurements, we have got the y distributed around y bar. That's quite a reasonable argument. Now, y equal to y bar is our model, and I have drawn the line. Now, what is the error in our model? Say we have a point yi that is away from y bar. So the error is yi minus y bar. We always want error in squared form. So we can calculate the squared error for all the data points, and the total error in our Oates model is equal to summation of yi minus y bar squared. So you are summing for all I from 1 to n, that is for all the data. We call it total sum of squares error, TSS. Now we have fitted the linear model. We got it by linear regression. Here y is linearly dependent on x. Suppose the equation of this blue line that is obtained by linear regression is y hat equal to mx plus c. When x equal to xi, y hat is equal to yi hat. What is the error in this linear model? For the point xi yi, the error is yi minus yi hat. Again, we take the square of this error and sum the squared errors of all the data points. And by summing, we get a total error of the model, the linear model. That is the residual sum of squares error of our linear model. In short, we call it RSS. Fine, we have got TSS and RSS. Now we ask, how good is our linear model with respect to the Oates model? To answer this question, compare these two errors of these two models. We subtract the error of the linear model from that of the Oates model, and then divide that value by the error of the Oates model. So we have TSS minus RSS divided by TSS. This can be written as 1 minus RSS by TSS. We call this R squared. Note, this R is capital R. Often the Pearson correlation coefficient of a data is written as lowercase r. We should not mix that with this R squared. R squared is known as the coefficient of determination. Let me write R squared showing all the terms explicit. R squared is equal to 1 minus summation of yi minus yi hat whole square divided by summation of the square of yi minus y bar. Sometimes R squared is written in a different fashion. Let me show that. I'll skip lot of many steps, but you can try the derivation using the clues that I will give you here. For linear regression, we have considered that yi hat equal to mxi plus c. By the least squares method, we have got m and c. You know the equations for that. Using these relations, it can be shown that the summation of the square of yi minus y bar is equal to the summation of the square of yi minus yi hat plus the summation of yi hat minus y bar square. Remember, here yi is the data, yi hat is the value from the fitted line, and y bar is the average of the data. Now, the left hand summation is the TSS. The first summation on the right hand side is the RSS. Now, we are left with another summation. Summation of the square of yi hat minus y bar. This is called the ESS. Explain sum of squares. So TSS is equal to RSS plus ESS. Use this equation to rewrite R squared. That gives you R squared is equal to summation of the square of yi hat minus y bar divided by summation of the square of yi minus y bar. In other words, R squared is equal to ESS by TSS. Now check the terms on the numerator and denominator. You will notice that R squared is actually a ratio of variance of y hat, that is the variance of our fitted model, and variance of y, the original data. Fine, we can write R squared in different forms, but what does a specific value of R squared obtained for our regression model tell us about the fitted linear model? When RSS is equal to TSS, that means the error in the fitted linear model is same as that of the Oort's model, R squared is zero. So in that case, our fitted linear model is an extremely bad model. When our linear model has exact fit to the data, then there is no error and RSS is equal to zero. In that case, R squared is equal to one. So a perfectly fitted linear model will have R squared equal to 1. But in most real data, R squared will be somewhere between 0 to 1. You will use linear model only when you notice a linear trend in the data. So rarely R squared will be 0. Similarly, real data has noise. So you can never fit a line exactly to the data. R squared will be less than 1. In general, the thumb rule is closer the R squared to 1, our linear model has better fit. Now, can R squared be negative? Yes, it can be. When RSS is bigger than TSS, R squared will be negative. But in real life, that is unusual. Let's take an example. So I have a data where Y has nonlinear relation with it. Now, suppose I do linear regression to fit a straight line with zero intercept. Okay, if I do regression, I will get a fit and I will get a line y equal to mx. But you can easily say that this fitting of this line to this nonlinear data is absurd. In fact, I took some xy value having this type of behavior and distribution and calculated the r squared after fitting y equal to mx. It was negative. We have learned Pearson correlation coefficient earlier. That also shows linear association or trend in our data. Is there any relation between Pearson's correlation coefficient and R squared? In fact, there is. I will discuss that relation but not derive it. It says R squared is equal to the square of rho of y and y hat. This rho is the Pearson correlation coefficient between the data and the fitted model. In other words, it is the correlation between yi and yi hat. So R squared is equal to the square of that correlation coefficient. Usually you will be using R, Excel or any other statistical tool for the linear regression. All those tools calculate and report R squared for linear regression. For our old data, I performed linear regression using Excel and the reported R squared is 0.8462. It's a reasonable good fit. That's all for this video. Thank you.